In this session, I'll be going to explain circulator, how circulator functions, what is the internal structure of circulator, and at last, we will be observing one application of circulator. So circulator in microwave is a device which is what circulating signal from one port to other port. So to understand that, let us have a circulator of microwave test bench. We have one circulator which we can see in this video, where it is what clockwise arrow which we can see over here. So as per this direction in circulator, if I give input from this port, output will be over here at this port, and at this port output will be zero. So if we consider this is a port 1, this is a port 2, and this is a port 3, then if input is given at port 1, output at port 2 will be same to input port, and output at port 3 will be 0. Similarly, if we give input at port 2, output at port 3 will be there as per input given at port 1, port 2, and output at port 1 will be 0. And similarly, if we give input at port 3, output will be there at port 1, and output at port 2 will be 0. So that is how circulator functions. So let us try to understand circulator functioning with respect to four port circulator. So that is what I am going to draw over here. So I have a four port circulator which is what getting circulated like this. Let us say this is port 1, this is port 2, this is port 3, and this is port 4. So in this, if we give input at port 1, output is getting circulated in clockwise direction. So output will be forwarded to port 2, and output at port 3 and port 4 will be 0. If we give input to port 2, output will get circulated to port 3, and output at port 4 and port 1 will be 0. Similarly, for port 3 input, output will be at port 4, and output at port 1 and port 2 will be 0. So that is how this complete device is getting functioned. So to understand that, let us try to understand that it with respect to internal structure of that. So here we have four port circulator's internal structure, where I have port 1 over here, port 2 over here, port 3 over here, and port 4 over here. So we insert, let us consider a case where we give input at port 1. So if I give input at port 1 with dominant mode TE10, that will getting inserted into rectangular waveguide. So that is this. So now this signal is going inside in rectangular waveguide with dominant mode TE10. Now when it goes inside, this rectangular waveguide is getting translated into circular. So once it goes inside, now after it is getting translated into circular waveguide, that mode will be now TE11 mode. Now if we see this port 1, its orientation is this, and orientation of port 3 is completely out of phase to the port 1. So the signal which is what we are inserting from port 1, that cannot transfer to port 3. The reason is that is out of phase. Now here in between port 3 and port 4, there is a ferrite rod. So this ferrite rod will circulate this signal in clockwise direction by 45 degrees. So when this signal is getting circulated in 45 degrees, even port 4 will be in out of phase to the input which is inserted at port 1. So output at port 4 will be 0, and that is what progressing further ahead, and we will be observing output at port 2 that will be the similar to the input, which is what we are inserting at port 1. So again, let us try to understand this. Whatever input that we insert at port 1 in rectangular waveguide, that will be there with TE10 mode. Once it passes through rectangular to circular waveguide, that signal is getting translated into TE11 mode, and its orientation is perpendicular to the orientation of port 3, so output at port 3 will be 0. And then after, there is a ferrite rod, which is what circulating a signal by 45 degree in clockwise direction. So port 4 is even out of phase to the signal which is reaching over here from port 1. And when we see that signal which is there at port 2, that is what exactly in the phase of port 1, so we can get output at port 2. Now let us take one more example so that we can understand what happens inside. If we give input at port 3, and that is what TE10 mode. So if I give input at port 3 with TE10 mode, its orientation is this. Now when it passing through this ferrite rod, it is getting circulated by 45 degree. So now its orientation will be in the orientation of port 4. So whatever input that we give at port 3, that is getting translated to port 4. So that is how internally the signals are getting propagated and output can be achieved. So as per this basic block diagram, we can understand if input is given at port 1, output will be there at port 2, and at other ports output will be 0. Similarly, if input is there at port 3, output will be there at port 4, and at other ports like port 1 and port 2, output will be 0. Now let us try to understand one very interesting application of circulator. So we can use circulator as a duplexer. So this is very interesting application which is practically used in so many devices, like in communication system. Basically, in communication system we can use circulator as a duplexer. Now to have that, let us consider a circulator of 4 port. So I have a circulator of 4 port. Let us say this is port 1, this is port 2, this is port 3, and this is port 4. And this circulator is revolving signal like this. Now here, to have this circulator as a duplexer, what I do is I will be connecting radar transmitting circuit over here. So let us say this is what transmitting circuit, and here I will be connecting antenna. Here I will be connecting antenna. Now at port 3 I will be going to connect receiving circuit, and at port 4 I will be going to connect match load, means match termination. Now see in this circuit how this circulator can function as a duplexer. Duplexer aim is to provide transmitting and receiving circuit using single antenna. Now what is the problem where we use single antenna for transmitting and receiving circuit? When we use single antenna for transmitting and receiving circuit, at that time major problem is there with respect to isolation of transmitting circuit and receiving circuit. Basically, transmitting circuit that functions at megawatt in radar, and if we see receiving circuit, so that is functioning at milliwatt in radar. So if we see power level difference in between these two, so that is there in terms of 10 to the power 9 times power difference, in between transmitting and receiving circuit. So transmitting circuit radiates extremely high power to the antenna, and receiving circuit receives extremely low power from the antenna. So that's why it is very essential to isolate these two circuits, and if we use single antenna for that, we use duplexer where we provide isolation to transmitting and receiving circuit, as well as both circuits can use single antenna for transmission as well as reception. So here we have a duplexer by using circulator. Now if I give signal at port 1, which is having transmitting circuit of this radar, then that signal will propagate to antenna, and signal which is given at port 1 will not reach port 3 and port 4. So output at port 3 and port 4 will be zero. Now when some signals are arriving to antenna, we need to give it to receiving circuit. So here received signal at antenna is connected to port 2, and that signal is getting forwarded to receiving circuit, and at other ports that signal will be zero. So whatever signal that has been received by antenna, that will reach to this receiving circuit of radar, which is functioning at very low power. So ultimately signal will get received from antenna to receiving circuit of radar. Now if I say there is some mismatch in this receiving circuit of antenna or in receiving circuit, in that case, because of mismatch, signal from port 3 will propagate towards port 4. If we provide match termination at port 4, then that signal completely absorbed at match termination. So now further reflection will not propagate inside this loop. So here this circulator transfers signal from transmitting circuit to antenna, and it receives signal from antenna to receiving circuit. So here it is doing double job of isolation as well as duplexer job in this complete circuit. So we can use circulator as a duplexer in microwave circuits. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you like, then please subscribe my channel, and definitely in future I'll be going to solve so many problems. So please subscribe my channel and write your questions so that I can solve out those problems. Thank you so much for watching.